difficult for Yoda in terms of navigation. He can't kart for free because Tornado beats kart every time.
Yes.
Hindsight has
no. Actually, I was watching him play against Bran, and if he's
that's actually
very
was gonna reference.
if he specifically goes through the tornado without his head touching it, he will armor through it. I was seeing Bran do that earlier.
Good to know.
Yeah, no, there is definitely counterplay. This is going to be, on paper, it's a rough matchup for Bowser Jr. For one, Meef Swordfighter's forward air is just a really good anti-air option.
Yeah,
and Bowser Jr. kind of, his ground moves besides kart are kind of,
Yeah, but like the, at least for Bowser Jr., like the main thing is that if he learns how to, like if he plays a matchup slow, understands that a lot of projectiles are going to be in his way, he can actually bait a lot of reckless jumps out of Hindsight, which he's doing right now. He's actually controlling him well. But Hindsight has kill confirms with down throw to up air for a long time, and he has tornado to up air for a long time. So Yoda has to respect that once he gets around like 80 to 90-ish, going all the way out there trying to catch him with the forward air, but Hindsight's going to make it back.
Yeah, I don't know how much respect he really needs to pay at this point. He is looking dominant at this moment. Yoda Cage, even when he gets hit, he's not eating that much. And this is Bowser Jr., a character that usually, when you touch him, you take him for a ride.
Yeah, and also, I mean, he does the same too. Those off airs just get so much damage. Tries to go for stagger jab, but rapid jab, that might kill here. No, not enough just yet. In center stage, you saw how Hindsight was wiping his hands. I think he assumed he was going to die. But unfortunately for Hindsight, does not make it back there. And Yoda Cage not going near him to make sure he does not hit him on the way back and just recover on the left-hand side.
Yeah, really smart there. Bowser Jr.'s recovery is kind of incredible. He can choose which side of the stage he comes back from easily.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, this is... if you are Hindsight at this point, what are you looking for to actually get a kill here?
Still looking for down throw up air for about maybe 5-ish more percent. But once it gets out of his range, you need tornado for about... All right, now you only have tornado, but in a... pretty soon, it's not going to work. So you're going to have to look for that hard read back air. But right now, getting hit by the up B, reaching out there to try and catch with forward air, and then the option coverage coming in from Yoda Cage. Forward air, force the air dodge. Exactly. Keeping him stuck, Salty.
Yeah, Yoda Cage is looking so good right now. Look at all of this damage. It's even extending that Bowser Jr. jab. It's just, it hurts, man. Not only does it kill, it does damage. It's good at high percent, low percent, all percent. And how is he surviving? He's at 170, and it feels like he's going nowhere.
Orton is heavy, bro. As you see, he tried to find down tilt the back, like a back air, maybe catch him on a shield poke. But this is where Meef Swordfighter struggles. Once it gets around here, there's not really much for true kill confirms. You have to find something like an F tilt or a hard smash attack. Rapid Jet's gonna put him deep off stage. Pretty much, we're looking at a situation right now where this is Yoda Cage just outplaying the match. Like, the matchup may be a little bit annoying, but he is outplaying Hindsight right now. And that was a dominant three stock.
It felt like the major strengths that Meef Swordfighter would have in the matchup just didn't come up.
Mm-hmm.
It felt like he wasn't effectively able to space around Yoda Cage's aerials because Yoda Cage wasn't blindly aerialing.
Yep.
You know, he wasn't just like jumping out, let me just like throw out back airs and forward airs and neutral airs. No, he wasn't doing that. He was being very careful. You saw a lot of cannon shots to like cover whatever next thing he was going to be doing. And on top of that, the Mecha Koopa to basically stymie a lot of ground movement. It felt like the approach in neutral. He had a game plan, he followed it, and it came to fruition. So as we move into game two, I'm really curious what adjustments Hindsight needs to make, because it felt like there were several stages in that.
This is one of them. I was going to say, I wasn't blaming it too much on the stage, because Yoda Cage was actually, even without platforms, probably would have navigated around him anyways, but we're going to see FD as the counter pick here, because he's going to go to a flat stage. He's going to force Yoda Cage to approach him linear. Now all of those chakram tosses and all those tornadoes become more of a viable option to not just like catch the cart, but also just to check Yoda's approach. As we see Yoda already starting off immediately saying, look, this state does not matter to me. I'm still going to run up on you.
Yeah, and all right, now we're already off the bat. I was saying how, forward air is a really good anti-air option, but we didn't see it. Now we're seeing a lot more of these aerial moves trying to shut down Yoda Cage's movement, and it seems to be working, at least for now.
Yeah, as he finds a roll punish right there with that. And this is what we talked about before. All you need is one side B in a dream as Morton. You just get that. You get all those up airs. So all that damage you worked for, it just disappears so fast. So you can see Yoda Cage is capitalizing more on the single hits that he gets in vantage shape versus trying to navigate around all the pressures.
And I will say, I felt
you're dead.
Wow. Okay. It felt like Hindsight started to really play the neutral better, and then he got hit once. And it just felt like the damage differential, the cost of missing a single time in neutral just was so brutal. He took like 60, 70. Now we're into a little bit more of a, it's heading towards an even game here.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not sure exactly. Do you know if right now down throw up air would get a kill confirmed?
It should still be within range right now, but it doesn't look like there's going to be a chance. There's the coverage once again. Catching him with the up air. He does make it back that time.
That was so close to not making
it back. Down throw up air not in range anymore, so that answers that question, and things are just looking very rough. I think Yoda Cage understands. I'll take intentional hit. That time, though, that tornado will keep you in range.
Yeah, really good right there. You know, the flatter stage makes it a lot harder for Yoda Cage to get out of the corner.
Mm-hmm.
And just throwing out these moves to shut down wherever you think he's going to be, it seems to be working out. Already a lot of damage, but the question is, he's kind of been struggling to take stocks. You know, even though he has kill setups, it feels like Yoda Cage is just playing around them so well.
Yeah, I mean, Yoda Cage understands, like, what's your options? You got tornado, you got down throw. So what if I play around both of them? I'm going to make sure I air-to-air you a bunch and misses the grab right there to get some damage on. Yoda Cage just looking for some jumps and the single hit stagger jab to force the forward throw to get that shield up. Very smart. And covers him after he tries to stall with the tornado, too. He saw right through it.
Yeah, he is just... He really has an absolute read on what Hindsight is trying to do here. He is panicking, really just trying to throw out anything he can to get out of these bad spots, and it's not working out for him. Look at this, Yoda Cage already dealt 72%. He's only at 80. Oh, that was a really big reflector. We haven't really talked much about the reflector from Hindsight yet, because it honestly hasn't come up that much. It maybe changed ownership of the Mecha Koopa a few times, but for the most part, Yoda Cage, look at that, across the stage, all the way out there. That's a brutal 2-0. Really good stuff for Yoda Cage. Going to be moving on in the winner's bracket.
Excellently played well in the matchup there. Understood all the win conditions that Hindsight needed to succeed and just consistently just kept keeping him locked out of his win cons. Soon as he got too high on his recovery, couldn't go for any type of grabs. Soon as he got him off stage, frame trapped him like a monster. And then as soon as that air dodge happened right there, like we saw a second ago, with that Mecha Koopa toss, capitalizing on it and taking it.
Oh, yeah. Now, I'm honestly looking really forward to seeing what else Yoda Cage can do in this bracket. It feels like he's always putting up really good results, but I'm waiting for, like, a real breakout performance from him. You know what I mean? And based on the way he's playing, maybe that's going to be tonight. I'm not sure who's on his who's going to be in the way of his warpath, but whoever it is, regardless of their of how good they are, they've got to be sweating based on how he's playing right now.
Yeah, like it is not going to be a fun time for anybody who has to deal with Yoda Cage as time goes on throughout the day. As he gets warmed up, he becomes stronger and stronger, piloting a character that is rough for a lot of people to pilot at a high level. Consistently fighting people like Mercury out in PA, not an easy thing to do on a regular day-to-day basis. Or is it Jersey? No, it's PA. It's hard to fight those type of matchups. He's out there winning with this character, that, again, very unique, very niche. You don't see it too often, but succeeding with that character nonetheless. And once again, taking on a matchup that, even though Hindsight has a lot of like history in, did not matter.
Yeah. Okay.